وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أما بعد إخوان, I request once again, can you move forward please, barakallahu feekum. Those of you that are sitting on the back wall, if you do not have a problem with your backs, then it is the sunnah to come close as far as possible to the one that is delivering the information, as that is from the sunnah, the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They would be close to the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So if you do not have a back problem and there is no excuse, then move as far possible as forward as you can. To proceed, Ikhwan, it is said that a nadam, something that brings about regret, something that brings about sadness, is يتعلق بالماضية. It is connected with the past. That when a person is remorseful and regretful, and something that saddens him, is a lot of the times connected with that which has passed. والخوف and fear, a lot of the time is connected with that which is about to come. Waqt, Ikhwan, this word that you have heard time and time again. Time is such a thing, Ikhwan, that will never come back once it's gone. Time, once it passes you by, you can never bring that back. This is why Allah Azza wa Jal swears by time. وَالْعَصْرِ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَتَوَاسَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاسَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ. Allah swears by time, by asr. And then Allah Azza wa Jal, He mentions that mankind is in a state of loss. That's the first wasf, the attribution which Allah says regarding mankind. Lost. Except for those who work, except for those who believe and work righteous actions and advise each other with the haqq and likewise advise each other with patience. If Allah Azza wa Jal swears by time, then you know, as Ahlul Ilm they have mentioned, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He swears by His creation, by something to do with the creation, يَدِلُّ عَلَى حَمِّيَتِهِ, that He shows you regarding the importance of that particular thing. Let's analyze. This is the way to be, Ikhwan. This is the way the Salaf work. Always checking ourselves. What we do with our time. Or what have we done with our time. Always looking to see if there's improvement. This is how the mu'min and the believer should be. Constantly making muraqabah of himself. Checking himself. What has he done in his time? The time that has gone. What did he do? And once again, we look and analyze the Quran and the Sunnah. And we analyze the life of the Salaf. Qudwatuna. They are our example. And we listen to what they say. And we see how they were regarding their waqt. عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله تعالى عنه قال إني لأمقت الرجل أن أراه فارغا ليس في شيء من عمل الدنيا ولا عمل الآخرة. ابن مسعود رضي الله تعالى عنه, he says, I detest and dislike to see a man that does not busy himself regarding acquiring the sustenance to support himself in this dunya. عمل الدنيا, to sustain his family, to be able to look after himself and those who he's been appointed in charge over. He does not busy himself with that. And likewise, he does not busy himself with the akhirah, with actions with the akhirah. So this individual, neither does he do any khair regarding acquiring sustenance for this life, to provide for his family and for himself, he even does not prepare for the akhirah. Ibn Mas'ud said, I dislike such an individual. And Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu قال, تعود الخير فإن الخير عادة. Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, get familiarized, familiar yourself, busy yourself with good. For verily good, it has a return. It has a return. If you carry out good, there is a return for that. الثمرات الطيبة, the fruits of that in this life you will see, and likewise in the hereafter. الحسن البصري رحمه الله تعالى, he mentions, يا معشر المسلمين إياكم والتسويف سوف أفعل سوف أفعل. الحسن البصري, he mentioned رحمه الله تعالى, be warned O Muslims regarding this thing, referring to تسويف. تسويف is to say, سوف أفعل, that I am going to do. That when there is something that needs to be done, you say, سوف أفعل, that I am going to do, but it never comes around. Likewise, if we look into the ways and the life of the Salaf, you will find some gharaib. Hassan al-Basri, when he was attending a funeral, he said, رحم الله امرأ عن عمل بمثل هذا اليوم, that may Allah Azza wa Jal have mercy for the one that strives for this day, meaning his day in the grave, the one that prepared himself for that day when he will be under, when he will be looking up, not looking down. So Hassan al-Basri says, may Allah have mercy upon the one that prepares for this day. إِنَّكُمَ الْيَوْمْ تَقْدِرُونَ عَلَى الْعَمَلِ لَا يَقْدِرُوا أَلَيْهِ إِخْوَانَكُمْ مِنْ هَؤُلَاءِ, meaning أصحاب القبور. He said, you, meaning the ones that are standing now, you have the ability over your brothers, meaning the brothers that are in the graves, they no longer have the ability to carry out actions. But you have the ability. And then he went on to mention, فَاغْتَنِمُوا صِحَّ وَالْفَرَاغِ قَبْلَ الْفُزْعَ وَالْحِسَابِ. He said, then take from your health and your spare time before the fuz'a comes. Fuz'a, as Ahlul Ilm that I've mentioned, is the taking of the life, is the regret and the fear at the time of when your soul is being taken out. And likewise, the reckoning al-hisab, when you will stand before Allah Azza wa Jal. So take from your health and take likewise from your spare time before these two things come. And do not make the most important thing of your life just the man chasing the wealth or any other dunya affairs that will take you away from the haq. This was looked down upon with the Salaf. Sufyan al-Thawri rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentioned, إِنَّ أَحَدُهُمْ لَوْ سَقَطَ مِنْهُ الدِّرْحَمْ لَظَلَّ يَوْمُهُ يَقُولُ إِنَّا لِلَّهِ ذَهَبَ الدِّرْحَمِ. He said that one of you will perhaps lose a dirham. Dirham meaning money. That you may lose a pound, you may lose a dirham. And then you spend your day saying, we belong to Allah and I have lost my dirham. You spend the whole day worrying about that one dirham that you have lost. وَلَا يَقُولْ ذَهَبَ يَوْمِي مَا عَمِلْتُ فِيهِ. And you do not say that my whole day has gone wasted and I did not carry out any beneficial actions. You will find that that is not said nowadays. But we are in regret because we have lost a dirham. The Salaf, they were very, very staunch regarding protecting their time. The Salaf, it mentions that when they would leave their scholar, once they were taking knowledge, that the alim, he would say to them, فَتَفَرَّقُوا لعل أحدكم يقرع القرآن على الطريق. He said that when you leave, separate, go separate ways. Perhaps you can make muraja'a, revision of the Quran. وَمَتَ اجْتُمَعْتُمْ حَدَثْتُمْ. And when you meet, and then you can speak. That is to show you, ikhwan, that not even a minute was wasted. And even when you leave the dust, go in separate ways, perhaps you can make that muraja'a. Perhaps you can make that revision. Perhaps you can have that remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this was the way of the Salaf. Regarding that alim, Ibn Sakina, it mentions, لا يضيع شيئا من وقته وكنا إذا دخلنا عليه. He said regarding Ibn Sakina, this was an alim and he did not waste no time whatsoever. And if we came to this individual, this alim, then he would say to us, لا تزيدوا على السلام عليكم والمسألة. But when we would enter upon him, he would say, do not increase, then saying assalamu alaikum and the mas'ala that you have come for. That question or that topic that you wish to discuss, that fatwa that you require, nothing else. لِكَفَرْتَ الْحِسِ عَلَىٰ مُحَافَظَةِ الْوَقْتِ. Because he had hirs, protective over his time. And this is the way of the ulama. This is what we have seen from the scholars. Alhamdulillah, Allah Azza wa Jal has blessed us to travel to the Mamluka from time to time. And this, ikhwan, we have witnessed. I'll bring you to the story of our Shaykh, Shaykh Rabi, hafidhullah ta'ala. That whenever we go to Mecca, after performing the Umrah, the next thing that we do is to arrange a ziyarah to go and see the Shaykh. And a lot of the time, ikhwan, the Shaykh is either sick or the Shaykh is extremely busy. So on this one occasion, we went and prayed Maghrib at his masjid. So the Shaykh, he came, prayed with us, gave salams, and we tried to approach him. But because there were so many people around, we didn't manage to be able to mention that there are people here from Birmingham and from England. So it was just an ishara from far away. So we stayed up until Isha. And then Isha, the Shaykh came back, and we prayed with him. And then I said to the Shaykh, oh Shaykh, we have come from England, we would like to sit down. And the Shaykh said, I am very busy. So then we thought, khalas, the Shaykh is busy, will not see us. But as he was getting in his car, he turned around and he said, ta'alu, lakum khams daqa'iq. Come then. Something, he must have felt it in his heart. So he said, come, I will give you 5 minutes. And then the Shaykh, he came down and gave us some nasiha, which went on to last for 20 to 25 minutes, alhamdulillah. And thereafter he said, excuse me, I need to go back upstairs and continue my work. I have mountains of work to do. And remember, this man is in his 80s. This man is in his 80s. And he said, I have a lot of work to do. And he said that sometimes when I come downstairs, there is a mas'ala in my mind that I know that I must deal with. But due to my old age, when I come down, perhaps I will forget this. So excuse me, let me go back to my work. This is how, ikhwan, the ulama they are. Shaykh Muhammad bin Hadi likewise, he used to advise us and he used to say to us, اشتغلوا بالخير وإلا اشتغلتم بالسوء. He said, busy yourselves. Busy yourselves with good, or otherwise you'll be busying yourselves with evil. That is the haqiqa, ikhwan. Look to how you are living your lives. How do you spend your time? If it is not good, then know, ikhwan, that it is something that is not going to aid you. Why? Because the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned that this world is cursed. All of it which is in it is cursed. And then he mentioned the things which you have heard time and time again. The dhikr of Allah and that which comes with the worship of Allah and the alim and the muta'allim. So busy yourselves, as Shaykh Muhammad bin Hadi, he said, with good. Because if you are not busying yourselves with good, anything after khair and good is only shar. Hamad bin Salama, that great individual, rahimullah. There are many riwayat, many narrations describing how this man was. He said that you would not find this man except that he was muti'an. He was obedient, in obedience to Allah Azza wa Jal. If it was the time for the salah, you would find him praying. And if it was other than that, you will find that he would go and visit the sick. And he mentions, قَاعِدًا يُسَبِّحُ فِي الْمَسْجِدِ. And likewise, he will be sitting in the masjid, making remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal. This is how this individual was. So much that he received his attributes thereafter. The people used to say regarding him, كُنَا نَرَىٰ عَنَّهُ لَا يُحْسِنْ أَنْ يَحْسِيَ اللَّهُ. They would say about him, because of his excessive worship, not wasting time, his obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his clinging to the sunnah of the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, thereon it was attributed to him that we cannot see this man disobeying Allah. This is what they would say about him. That he's not a person that could disobey Allah. He's not a person that could be sinning. This is the thamarat, ikhwan. This is what happens, ikhwan, when you are busying yourself with khair. People have husna dhan. People have good suspicions regarding you. They think good of you. The love in their heart comes for you. But if you're an individual that wastes time, an individual that is constantly involving in shar and evil, and in the places of evil, then you will find that you will be often accused. That is something, ikhwan, that we should really, really reflect on. What has gone is gone. Those days that have passed us are finished. You can't bring them back. But we still have days in front of us. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla that He blesses us our time that we have left. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala knows best. Wa sallallahu ala wa barik ala Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وبعد. Once again, brothers, if you could try to move forward, please, if you can, make room for your brothers. Another miqyas that we can work with, another scales that we can work with to help us to check ourselves, is put the question to yourself that if the destroyer of pleasure, the angel of death, was to come and take your soul, then would you be satisfied in the state that you're in? Would you be satisfied with what you have put forth in the meeting with your Lord? كان عبد الرحمن بن عبد النعيم لو قيل له قد توجع إليك الملك الموت قال ما كان عنده زيادة العمل أو زيادة العمل. Now this individual, it mentions regarding Abdul Rahman ibn Abi Na'im that if it was said to him that the angel of death is heading towards you, then this person could not increase in his righteous actions, meaning that his day and night was filled with righteous actions, filled with making istifada, that there would be no more that he could do. Al-waqt la yi'ud. The time, it will never return. Ahmad ibn Mas'ud qal, anta fi hadni umrik mundhu kharajta min batni ummik. He mentions, rahimullah, that you are taking from your life the day you left your mother's stomach. You are taken from your life. The very day that you was born, every day that goes, you are taken from your life. And that's why Al-Hasan al-Basri, he mentions, Ya Ibn Adam, إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ الْأَيَّامِ. O son of Adam, you are nothing but a number of days. وَكُلَّمَا ذَحَبَ الْيَوْمِ ذَحَبَ بَعْضًا. And every day that goes, a part of you is going. فَكَيْفَ الْبَكَى. So strive in that time that you have remaining. Strive in that time that you have remaining to do good. Likewise, Al-Hasan al-Basri, in this bab regarding the protection of time and the raqa'iq, in bab al-fa'idah that he has been given the laqab of tibb al-qalb, the doctor of the heart, a fa'idah which our brother Abu Musa Ziyad, hafidhullah ta'ala, one of the students that was in Medina, he now lives in Morocco, in my recent trip to him, when this was mentioned, he said, I heard Sheikh Salih al-Fawzan, rahimahullah ta'ala, he said that this was this attribute that has been given to Ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullah ta'ala, tibb al-qalb, to be the doctor of the heart, rather the doctor of the heart is al-Nabiyyu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is what Sheikh al-Fawzan, hafidhullah ta'ala, has mentioned, that the one who gives life to your heart is very the sunnah of the Messenger of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. However, he is indeed a great alim and an imam. He mentions, min alamat al-i'rad Allah an al-abd an yaj'ala shaghlahu fi ma la yu'ni. That he said, Hasan al-Basri rahimahullah ta'ala, that from the signs that Allah turns away and abandons a servant is that he makes that servant busy his time with that which does not concern him. That is from the alamat, from the signs that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala turns away from a slave. That he makes that slave busy himself with that which does not concern him. That's not bringing him no form of benefit. And then he went to say, Ya ayyuha an-nas, لو لم يقل لنا الذنوب إلا حب الدنيا لخشينا منها. Went on to mention that all mankind, if there was no other sins upon the earth except for حب الدنيا, loving the life of this world, if that was the only sin, even then we would fear for ourselves. And then he quoted the statement of Allah Azza wa Jal, تُرِيدُونَ عَرَضَ الدُّنْيَا وَاللَّهُ يُرِيدُ الْآخِرَةَ. And then he quoted the verse that verily that you desire and want the life of this world, the good of this world, but Allah Azza wa Jal wants for you the good of the hereafter. And then Hasan al-Basri, he went on to mention, فَرَحِمُ اللَّهُ إِمْرَأً أَرَادَ مَا أَرَادَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلْ. May Allah Azza wa Jal have mercy upon that person who wishes and wants that which what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he wants. And in conclusion, and to finish off from that great imam once again, Al-Hasan al-Basri rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentions, إِنَّمَا الدُّنْيَا ثَلَافَةَ أَيَّامِ. That this world is 3 days only. Taqseem, it has categorized it into 3 days. مَضَى أَمْسْ بِمَا فِيهِ. That which has passed yesterday, it is gone. So that which came in the past, it is gone. That was a day. وَغَدًا لَعَلَّكَ لَا تُدْرِكُهُ. And tomorrow, and perhaps you will not reach that day. And then he went on to mention, فَانْظُرْ مَا أَنْتَ عَامِلٍ فِي يَوْمِكَ. So then look to see what you carry out in your day to day. So the past is gone. The future, you may not even reach. All you have is the day that you're in today. So look to what actions you do. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal that He blesses us to do those actions that will be pleasing to Him. Those actions that will bring us closer to His mercy, closer to entering us into the paradise, and will give us protection from the hellfire. And Allah Azza wa Jal knows best. أقول قول هذا أستغفر لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. أقيموا الصلاة يا رب العالمين.